Yeah, this is Bristol, the Delta Sigma modulator revisited. So we have analog input U and then integrator here, which is delaying integrator. Delaying. Let's see, if you rewrite this equation, so we have a delaying operator in a numerator, right? We need at least one delaying element around the loop for stability. Yeah, the next one is a quantizer, which is 1-bit ADC. Yeah, we can increase this resolution into multi-bit, 3-bit or 5-bit. But in this example, we use 1-bit quantizer. This 1-bit quantizer can be implemented by latched comparator. Latched comparator. So this latched comparator compares this analog output, which is integrator output, with a zero if y is positive. V is latched to 1. If y is negative, V is minus 1. So it keep this VG keep that value during 1 time interval, nt and n plus 1t. So this VG doesn't change during this time interval, okay, 1 or minus 1. So we need a latched comparator for that. So representative latched comparator circuit is this. Yeah, we have this input D. Yeah, this input, this is Y. Yeah, this may be connected to some reference, which is 0 volt, okay? So we have NMOS input differential pair here. And then this is a inverter. Say we have this inverter and that inverter. They are cross-coupled inverter, and then some clock circuitry here, there, some pre-charge. So this output S bar, and then reset bar, set bar, reset bar, is connected to a SR latch here. That SR latch is a cross-coupled type of this is SR latch. Two input NAND gate, okay? So this is a Q. This is a Q bar. Yeah, this circuit can work as a latched comparator. Latched comparator. Yeah, let's look at the behavior of this circuit. Behavior of this circuit. Yeah, we can rewrite this circuit. See, we have input Y here. And then NMOS input differential pair here, reference 0. And then we have a NMOS circuit connected to clock. And here we have an inverter here. Inverter, yeah. There are cross-coupled inverter here, right? One inverter and another inverter. So they are cross-coupled to each other. So this inverter is connected to one side, PMOS side connected to VDD, and then NMOS side is connected to this NMOS differential pair. And then, yeah. Let's see. So let's look at the previous slide. Yeah, inverter output is elsewhere, okay? Alright. So those inverters are cross-coupled. This output of one inverter is connected to input of the other inverter. Yeah, this output is also connected to the other inverter. Okay. Then, you know, those inverter outputs are, let's just see, this can be set bar or reset bar, which is a set bar. Set bar is input of output of right hand side inverter. Is it right? Nope. Left hand side inverter. Oops. Set bar. This may be set bar. This may be reset bar. Okay. Then I have another transistor here for pre-charge. So PMOS transistor connected there. This is a clock. Okay, is it correct? Yeah. Looks like this is a set bar. Set bar, this is a reset bar, okay? So, yeah, this is a latch. This latch is connected to another SR latch. Then it forms a flip-flop, which is a rising edge triggered flip-flop, okay? The circuit works this way. When clock is zero, yeah, this node voltage is pre-charged to VDD. Okay, VDD, VDD. Both S bar and R bar pre-charged to VDD. Oh, I missed one thing. I have some extra circuitry, something like that, MOS. Sometimes we don't need this one. Okay, so let's see. Because this clock is zero, this tail current source is turned off, so you know this voltage is VDD minus VTH by this shunt MOS transistor. So all those voltages are high voltage. Okay, so yeah, this is a up, right? While clock is zero. Okay? Yeah, when clock goes from zero to one, you know, this transistor turns on, and then see, this transistor flows some current, and then, you know, if Y is positive, then more current will flow through this way, right? Then right hand side. Then, you know, this voltage will be dropped more than this voltage drop, right? So if this, by this positive feedback of this cross-coupled inverter, you know, if you look at the, if this is negative, then if this goes negative, and then by the MOS transistor operation of this inverter, this voltage goes large negative, right? And then if this goes negative, this goes to positive. Actually, it stays there. It stays at the VDD. So if Y is positive, this set bar goes low voltage, zero. and then this reset bar remains at the 1. Okay. Then see, because S bar, R bar is connected to NAND SR latch here. See, because S is a 0, Q becomes 1, and Q bar is a 0. Okay. Yeah, this operation occurs during this transition time, the transition time why clock changes from 0 to 1 and remains that value. Yeah, while the clock remains at 1. Okay, this is CK. So, you know, this latch circuit watches the input Y during the during this transition time and keep the S and R values while clock is 1. Okay, then when clock returns to 0, then S bar and R bar both are 1, both goes to VDD. Okay, then because this is 1 and 1, then Q doesn't change. Okay, so you know, because Y is positive, you know, Q, this Q value just remain the same, right? Well, yeah, after clock to Q delay, clock to Q delay, and then it changes this high value, and then remain the same until the next rising edge of CK. So it is a positive edge triggered flip-flop. So here see, you can see we implement this strong arm latch using minimum size transistors, all minimum size transistors. And then see, yeah, this is my input. See, this is D, this is D bar. Okay, in this case, this is a differential, right? Then this is a Q. Okay, I didn't specify clock edge, but at the clock edge, you know, as soon as D is larger than D bar, Q is 1. If D is smaller than D bar, Q goes to 0. So it works fine.